Elon Musk wants to buy all of Twitter. What's a money page and how do you optimize one? And how a beautiful infographic of a sandwich can help you create better blog posts. All this and more in this week's Fishbowl Friday. Welcome to Fishbowl Friday, where we've gathered the best marketing news from this week and compiled it down into this quick 5-minute bite-sized video just for you. To access the full version of each week's stories, go to fishbowlfriday.com. While you're there, be sure to subscribe to receive our weekly marketing news straight to your inbox. Let's get to it. Not every page of your website carries the same level of importance to your site visitors. There are certain pages that generate revenue. These are called your money pages. Typically, these are your service pages, product pages, and landing pages. They contain clear calls to action and encourage site visitors to make a purchase or fill out a form. So how do you identify your current money pages? A good start is by reviewing your Google Analytics and looking for the most visited pages of your website. Look at what the calls to actions are on these pages. If there are no CTAs or they're kind of weak, this is a really quick win. Also, consider adding targeted keywords and building backlinks to these pages to help increase the rankings of these money pages on the search engines to drive more traffic to these revenue-generating pages of your website. Also consider positioning clear marketing messaging that conveys the value you provide to help your buyer personas overcome the pain they want to avoid or pleasure they seek. This is going to help your site visitors understand quickly how you can help them. Our take on this, if you want to increase revenue with your website, money pages are the pages on your website to take action. Focus your attention on optimizing these pages to clearly present your value, demonstrate how you've helped others, and present a compelling call to action that will get site visitors to complete the action you want them to take. Our next story is build the perfectly published sandwich. Is your content strategy feeling crusty or stale? Be a hero to your customers by creating a perfectly published content sandwich. Keep the bologna to a minimum, add a dash of wry humor to give it a tangy zip, and you can be sure your content will cut the mustard. If your content's a sinking sub, let us put you onto this awesome infographic from LinkedIn about how to get on a roll with your content. This fantastic visual breaks down the ingredients of a perfect post, giving you a recipe for a piece of content that hits all the key elements. Our take on this, deli humor aside, this infographic shows you the layers of ingredients you need to make a perfect content post. Eye-catching visuals, supporting introductory paragraphs, smooth transitions, the meat or main point of your content, and then wrapped up with an enticing CTA. Seems like the chef's kiss of sandwiches in our book. And our next story, digital advertising is up 35% to $189 billion in 2021. When the pandemic shut down most of the country in 2020, a lot of advertisers paused campaigns in fear of the unknown. Some carried on, and a few took advantage of decreased demand and doubled down on cheap ads. Everyone expected 2021 to be a strong year for digital ad growth, but the newly released IAB Internet Advertising Revenue Report for 2021 shows a surprising rate of growth for digital advertising spends. This is consistent with a recent Harvard Business School study showing the internet economy has grown 7 times faster than the U.S. economy over the past 4 years. Here are a few of the metrics. Digital video continues to lead the growth, up 50.8% with total revenues of $39.5 billion. Digital audio is up 57.9% to $4.9 billion. Social media advertising was up 39.3% to $57.7 billion, and search revenue grew 32.8%. According to the IAB, the forecast continues to look solid for digital ad growth for 2022 and years to come. Our take on this, data supports what a lot of businesses are thinking. Marketing fuels business growth. There's a lot of opportunity in digital audio and video for small business owners right now. Look where the money goes and don't wait until everyone's already at the party before you decide to go. Our next story, how to develop a social media strategy that drives brand awareness and ROI. If you're just starting out in business, chances are you've already claimed your social media channels. But what's the next step? It's not to post all the time with no formal strategy in place. Our friends at Digital Marketing Institute put together this comprehensive guide on how to build a social media strategy from the ground up. It covers what is a social media strategy? What are the benefits of having a social media strategy? Social media marketing strategy versus social media content strategy. What is a social media engagement strategy? What are the steps in building a social media strategy? What is a good example of a social media strategy? And social media strategies for small businesses. Like anything else, knowing the fundamentals is key to creating an effective strategy. This guide will help you gain a better understanding of how social media works so you can create an effective social media strategy to drive engagement and leads. Our take on this guide has everything you need to start using social media to market your business. Just remember, social media and any third-party platforms are only a tool and should be used as part of your marketing, not your entire strategy. In additional marketing news, last week, Twitter offered Elon Musk a seat on their board that came with handcuffs, capping his total common stock ownership at 14.9%. This week, Elon politely declined his offer and countered with an offer of his own, buying the entire company. Elon offered to purchase all of Twitter for $54.20 per share, which is a 38% premium from the stock's price uptick after his $3 billion investment. He feels Twitter has extraordinary potential and he's the person who can unlock it. Twitter said the board would review the proposal and any response would be in the best interests of Twitter shareholders. Everyone's feeling the pain of inflation right now, but there could be a silver lining if you look hard enough. The core CPI, which removes food and energy prices, came in below projections, which might indicate the March surge to 8.5% might be the peak. There are a lot of additional factors that will contribute to inflation leveling off, and it will likely take years for price growth to return to the Fed's 2% target. At this point, any indication we're heading in a better direction will be welcomed with open arms. Fingers crossed. Have a local service that targets homeowners? Nextdoor is rolling out a new user-friendly platform for advertisers to reach these homeowners in search of your services on their platform. To be clear, they've always had advertising opportunities on their platform. This new update will give advertisers a guided experience for creating and managing ads on Nextdoor much easier than ever before. Nextdoor claims that almost 1 in 3 U.S. households have a presence in the app, making this an appealing platform for local advertisers to get their services in front of this audience. And finally, inflation's forcing a lot of businesses to raise their prices. Etsy thought they'd join the price hike party, bumping transaction fees from 5% to 6.5%. 14,000 of Etsy's sellers banded together and went on strike to show their disapproval for Etsy's price increases. In addition to transaction fees, Etsy reserves the right to advertising products of sellers over $10,000 per year on third-party sites like Google, Facebook, and Pinterest, taking an additional 12% cut of those sales to cover ad costs. While 14,000 sellers is only a small portion of the 5.3 million active sellers on the platform, they hope to get Etsy's attention that they're fed up. Yet another reason why you need to own your marketing by collecting first-party data. Go ahead and use these third-party platforms, but do not rely on them and get mad when they change the rules. They are in the business of making money too. That's all the marketing news we have for you this week. Don't forget to subscribe to receive all this marketing goodness straight to your inbox and access the full version of these stories and more at fishbowlfriday.com.